What is Google Ads quality score and how do you improve it? That's what we're going to be talking about in this video. Ilana here from teachtraffic.com, recording a video for measureschool.com. And as mentioned, we're going to be talking all about quality score, specifically four parts to it. The first is, why is quality score important to you as an advertiser? The second is, what is quality score? The third is, where do you find it in your account? And lastly, how can you improve your quality score? So make sure you stay through to the end of this video. So here we are in a live Google Ad account. And importantly, before I start showing you where to find what your quality score is, we need to talk about why it's important. And essentially, it's important because it's going to affect what you pay on a cost per click level. All right. So yes, Google Ads is an auction, but it's an auction with a difference, whereby the person in the number one ad spot isn't necessarily paying the highest cost per click. It could be because they have a really good quality score, and therefore the relationship between quality score and ad rank formula means that they're put in the number one ad spot. Google are incentivizing you to have a good quality score so that it will reduce your cost per click. The second part to this video, which is, what is quality score? It's important to understand that quality score is a number between 1 and 10, 1 being the worst, 10 being the best, that Google assigns at a keyword level. There are rumors that Google have an account level quality score number, but these are rumors and they certainly don't tell you what that quality score is, but they do tell you what the quality score is at a keyword level. Essentially, there's three components that make up your quality score number. The first is click-through rate. The second is ad relevance, and the third is landing page experience. And I don't know about you, but I think that there's a direct correlation between the first two ones of click-through rate and ad relevance. Therefore, illustrating just how important it is for Google, essentially, that Google want people clicking on your ads, all right? So click-through rate and ad relevance, you need to really have your ad account managed well. I'm going to show you in a sec how to do that and how to improve it and write really good ad copy such that people click on your ads, because that's going to affect your quality score, which, as I said, is going to affect what you pay for a click, okay? So that's what quality score is. Now, to find where your quality score is, you need to navigate to the keyword section within a search campaign. So I have gone into one of my search campaigns, gone into an ad group, which has taken me to the keyword view. And as you can see here, these are the keywords that I'm bidding on, and these are the quality score which have been assigned at a keyword level. Now, the default view does not sort of show the quality score metric here. So you need to change your columns if you've logged into your account and you can't see it. So you go to columns, modify columns. I'm going to scroll down here. You'll see a quality score section. And then we need to check this one, which will bring up the quality score metric in your account. And as you can see here, I've got a different quality score for the different keywords in this particular ad group. You might also have a situation like I've got in this account where I've got a keyword which has no quality score, all right? And that's because it hasn't been assigned yet. And so Google just needs a bit more data before they give it a number. Okay, so don't worry, it will populate with time. As mentioned earlier in the video, there are three components that make up your quality score number. So if you're wondering how kind of Google got to this number 5, or what's really bringing it down or up, you need to bring up those three components in your columns to see what you can work on to improve. So if we go back to columns, modify columns, quality score here, you need to click these three elements, which are the three elements that make up your quality score, and then Google is going to tell you what's bringing it down. So we click apply and we scroll across here, and we can see that these are the three elements. So expected click-through rate for this particular keyword is below average, landing page experience is average, and ad relevance is above average. So really unanimously, Google's telling me in this ad group, I really need to work on improving my click-through rate. I'd say for most people, you're going to have to work on improving your click-through rate or ad relevance, because hopefully you're buying quality traffic, which means that the landing page experience is at least average. In this particular instance, we're sending people to a page that teaches them how to create a retargeting campaign on Facebook and Google, and we're bidding on those types of keywords. So I'm kind of not surprised that the landing page experience is okay, because we're sending quite targeted traffic, but really we just need to tighten up our campaign to improve the click-through rate, which leads me to the last part of this video, which is how you can improve your quality score. And obviously, as I said, it depends on what's bringing it down, but I'd say for most people, it's going to be click-through rate and ad relevance. So I believe there's three main ways to improve your click-through rate, which will in turn improve your quality score. The first is by adding negative keywords to your campaign or at the ad group level. A low click-through rate is a function of lots of impressions and not a lot of clicks. So by adding negative keywords, that will reduce the number of impressions and hopefully not reduce the number of clicks, or at least keep them the same, which will result in an improvement or an increase in your click-through rate. So if we go to the search term report and we rank by impressions, really what we're looking for here is a search term that has a lot of impressions with not a lot of clicks. So you're really looking at click-through rate here. And as you can see here, we've got retargeting Facebook ads, which has 7 viewer impressions and no clicks. This one here, Facebook retargeting ads, which has 61 impressions and no clicks. So we need to ask ourselves, why are these people who are searching for retargeting Facebook ads and Facebook retargeting ads not clicking? The first possible reason might be that they're not interested in purchasing a course. They're looking just for, you know, information or how-to guides, which is entirely possible. So we need to decide if this kind of feels not a match for the offer, in which case we could add this as a negative keyword, all right? Or we need to have a look at if this does feel like the right kind of term, possibly the ad that they're seeing isn't a match for what they've typed in, okay? So if we then go to look at our ads, we can see here that these ads talk about Google retargeting tutorials, at least at a headline level. So if you think about it, these people have just gone to Google and typed in retargeting Facebook ads and they're seeing an ad for Google stuff. They think, no, that's not relevant. I'm not going to click on it, leading to impressions and no clicks. So then that leads us to the third part of how we improve click-through rate, which is really restructuring our ad groups. And you want to structure your ad groups such that the term that somebody types in, the ad that they see for that term feels really relevant and it's a match, okay? So if I just show you, I've got my campaign level here and then I've got an ad group that has keywords that talks about Facebook retargeting. I've got a different ad group that talks about Google retargeting, retargeting course, etc. And the idea behind this is that the ad that is attached to this particular ad group talks specifically to that keyword, all right? So my Google retargeting ad group, which is this one, has an ad that talks all about Google retargeting. My Facebook retargeting ad group has an ad that talks all about retargeting on Facebook. So really what I actually need to do here is add Facebook as a negative keyword, but just at the ad group level, all right? Which will then force Google to show the ad that's attached to this Facebook retargeting ad group, and that will improve ad relevance and hopefully click-through rate. Okay, so adding a negative keyword just at the ad group level will hopefully improve the click-through rate of that particular keyword. All right, and once again, we just keep scrolling down our search term report to find other possible negative keywords to add, which will obviously reduce the number of impressions and improve our overall click-through rate. Here's another example, LinkedIn retargeting. I don't teach retargeting on LinkedIn at any part of the course, so I need to add LinkedIn as a negative keyword, but I'm going to add it at the campaign level because I don't want LinkedIn retargeting showing up in any of my ad groups. So I go to negative keywords. I've actually got it here already because this is an old time frame, and we just click plus here and we add it at the campaign level, and you just type in LinkedIn that way. Okay, so by adding negative keywords, possibly changing ad copy, and ultimately, if you need to, restructuring your ad groups will improve your click-through rate and hopefully, as a result, your quality score. So there you have it. That's all the information about quality score. Hope you enjoy this video. Stay tuned.
All right, thanks Ilana for this great information. If this video helped you out, then please hit that like button so we can share it more to other people. And if you want to find out more about AdWords tracking analytics, then check out this playlist right over there. And from everybody here at Measure School, happy measuring.